What's up, everybody, and welcome to the Minute Channel. And today we'll be talking about Far Cry New Dawn. So, spoiler review for Far Cry New Dawn. I apologize about this. First of all, there's a lot of games coming out, and there's a lot of games that I've been playing. So it's just kind of trying to get all these videos out on everything. But with me, I just want to take my time and kind of just play them and actually give you my review and everything like that. No worries, my gameplay is still going to be coming out. I know some people actually really like it. So I have some recorded, and I have multiple saves, so I'm going to just replay and everything like that, some sections for you and everything. So no worries about that. But yeah, I apologize about the delay on all these reviews and everything, but I do want to kind of just give you my thoughts out. And now that I finished the game, like I said, I just want to talk to you about everything and everything. Anyway, let's go ahead and get started with it. And as always, I'm going to go ahead and start with the story. So the story, it's okay. It's not super good, but it's all right. I will say, this is one of those things that Far Cry New Dawn, or Far Cry in general, usually have okay stories. Some more interesting than others, but overall, it's not really their strongest point. So going into these kind of games, I'm not usually kind of like being like, oh man, I'm not expecting Mass Effects or anything like that. So I'm kind of like, it's okay, you know. Overall, I like the protagonist and pretty much the area and everything. I think it's pretty interesting. Unfortunately, even though they have a really interesting setting, they don't really do much with it per se. There's a lot going on, you know. This is the post-apocalyptic environment and everything, and they don't really push it forward. I was expecting this game to really push forward with this setting of being post-apocalyptic, but they actually don't do this at all. And it's pretty interesting, being that this is an interesting concept that they could do more with. The villains are really weak in a sense, as far as the way that they are made and portrayed. So unfortunately, even though they have an interesting setting, everything is just set up to be an interesting thing, but they actually don't really do much with it. So I think this is a weakness that all the Far Cry games have already, but I think this one, being that they had such an interesting setup, I was maybe expecting a little bit more than what they did. But yeah, so I'm giving the story a 7 out of 10. I thought it was, like I said, an interesting concept, but maybe doing more with it would have been a good idea. Right, so let's go ahead and move it with the gameplay. And Far Cry are known for the interesting gameplay, and that's pretty much what I look for in these games. And this one did not disappoint in a lot of the stuff. This game plays pretty much like Far Cry 5, like 100% plays like Far Cry 5. The only difference, and this is kind of like why I'm diminishing the points, is actually this level system that they added to it. Ubisoft has started this new thing where they want to make more games in an RPG like. So a lot of the sections are level gated, which you have to be higher level in order to kill these faster and everything. To me, I actually love RPGs. I'm mostly focused on RPGs, but this is a really bad attempt into entering into the RPG genre, especially coming out of something like the latest Assassin's Creed game, which actually had a really, really good setup for RPG settings and everything. This one doesn't really do it for me. And I know a lot of games try to do it, but I think they should look at maybe games like Mass Effect to go something like this, or maybe Fallout has a really good way to kind of manage the areas and everything, but unfortunately this game doesn't for me. So I'm going to be giving gameplay an 8 out of 10. Like I said, overall it plays really good, and it plays like other Far Cry games. So it's not bad or anything, but I just feel like this attempt to kind of make it into more an RPG area is not really what I was expecting for, or kind of like what I wanted to see. I wanted to see a little bit more implemented, but this is a first attempt at it in the gun genre, which is completely different to how it plays with Assassin's Creed. Assassin's Creed was pretty, it was pretty good. I actually like how it went over there. All right, let's go ahead and move with the performance. This game looks amazing. This is actually their strongest point. It looks beautiful. The music, well accompanied with it. Most of the voice acting is kind of okay, but overall, the strongest point is really how beautiful this game looks. I like the aesthetic that they chose with this bright pink that they chose and everything. It's really cool. It looks amazing. I just can say, I even downloaded a wallpaper because I just wanted to have it on my computer and everything because of how beautiful it looks. And I just like how it looks. It's great. Unfortunately, I was expecting maybe a little bit more, you know. Unfortunately, in this area, everything just kind of looks like that aesthetic, but they don't rule again with the story wise and everything. They don't really do anything with it. They need to push it a little bit forward. They do something interesting with a lot of the different creatures, which look like they're mutated and everything, but they don't move forward with it a little bit more. You know, maybe push it a little bit. Now, maybe I'm being a little bit unfair on Far Cry New Dawn, because this is only a $40 game, so it's not a full price game. It's obviously a smaller scale and everything, but this game with this setting and everything just had much more potential for it, so I just want to expect that a little bit more. But performance, I'm gonna give it a 9 out of 10. Like I said, the game looked beautiful, it sounded great, and overall I think it was pretty good. All right, so let's go ahead and move to the last point. I think this will be fun. I had a lot of fun with this game, and usually with Far Cry games, I actually have a lot of fun with them. They're really fun, kind of just easygoing games. While I'm playing with Metro, and Metro is really stressful because it's more focused on the story and everything, this was just more an easygoing, relaxing kind of game. I can play a couple hours, record gameplay, and just kind of have some fun. And that's pretty much what I like these games, because they're really fun, really just relaxing, and I don't have to pressure or anything like that. Now, I do want to mention one spot on this area. There's microtransactions to this one, and Ubisoft at this point, you're just doing microtransactions on everything, really. And it's, I don't really care much for that, but I just have to mention it. It's in there. Now, however, I don't personally believe that it really affects the gameplay at all. So it didn't affect my experience with it. It didn't affect my fun or anything like that, which for that, I'm going to give fun a 9 out of 10. So it didn't really affect any of that stuff to me personally, but it's out there, so I just want to mention it. Maybe somebody will take offense on it or anything, but overall it just didn't really affect me at all. Alright, so overall I'm going to give this game an 8 out of 10. If you add all these points, you actually get an 8.25 out of 10, but I just want to give you an 8 out of 10. I do believe that this is a good game overall. Definitely worth the $40 price. If it was $60, so it's probably not worth the $60 price, but it's $40. So I believe the Ubisoft went with a good call on kind of just making that game a little bit cheaper. It is obviously smaller scale from the usual stuff they do, but I do think that this game had a lot of potential with the settings that they were moving forward and everything. And so it's a good game. So if you have $40 to spare, maybe pick this game up. It's a good game and it's pretty fun. Anyway, thanks so much for watching this video here. And if you agree or disagree, let me know in the comments below. Thanks so much for watching the video here. And if you're interested, I will be posting some more gameplay and everything. I have a couple hours more already recorded and everything, so I'll post that up and I'll continue the gameplay that I have already started with you guys online. All right, thanks so much for watching this video here. And if you're new, maybe consider subscribing or liking the video. Again, thanks so much for watching the video, and I'll see you next time.